Hi, Melanie here from Pretty Gets Gritty's design team, and in this video I'm going to be creating a reverse canvas with the Pretty Scenic collection with the door that I created in the first video. Okay, so today is the launch of the new 3D MDF doors and windows. And Lynette was live at 10 o'clock. So if you missed that one, please pop on over and take a look. Sorry, I should have taken a stencil out before. Right, so got a canvas and I've gessoed it with the new cream gesso that is now available on the website as well, and I am going to use some texture paste through the Pretty Ornate stencil. It doesn't matter if it's not perfect, it's just to add a bit of interest to the background. She says not perfect and starts wiping the back of the stencil. Watch that. There we go. And as you can see, this one is well loved and covered in ink. No doubt the texture paste will pick up the black versifying. Okay, thought I'd smudge it too much, but I haven't. Let's see if I can get this under this end without smudging too much of the other side. There we go. Make sure it is roughly straight, otherwise that's going to be standing out like a sore thumb. Thank you. Let's just wipe off. Okay. So we've got the texture paste added. So I've given that a quick dry to go on to the next step. So I've cut some brickwork from the pretty Gothic window die set, and this is the larger one. So get matte gel medium. And the scissors. So I want to add I had a plan. I did take a picture, but now I've forgotten how I was going to do it. I think, did that go in like that? Did I have them back to front? I think I did. Yes, I put them back to front. So I'm using the matte gel medium. That's straight. Looks it. Right, so I'll carry on sticking on the brickwork and then I'll bring you back. Right, so I've added in some of the die cuts, and at the moment it looks a bit strange. So I've chopped some of them up and put them there. Right, next step is roughly put the door where I want it. And I've die cut the Gothic window. Oops, I lost some of it. The pretty Gothic window, sorry. And chopped it up. And so this is going to sit above. And I think that's too high. Bring that down. This is cut out of grey board. It did take quite a few passes, but I didn't actually expect it to cut it. Depends which machine you've got as to whether they like cutting grey board or whether they don't. Some can be very finicky. Let's pop the side. Did that wrong, didn't I? Should have popped the side panels on first. Stick. I think that's straight. No, it's not. Me being too impatient again. So that's that one. So I've got one for the other side and one for up the top, and then the Gothic arch. So I'll stick those down and then bring you back. Right, so I've got the grey board in place and move the door out of the way. The top panel is one of the centerpieces that are cut out from the lower section. These pieces are part of the die as well. So utilizing what you've got on the die. Green gesso. So everything is going to get a quick coat of the gesso. And because I'd already gessoed previously, or at the beginning, should I say, it shouldn't take that much just to cover up the texture paste and the dyes. So I'll carry on gessoing. Right, so I've given that a quick coat of cream gesso, and the grey board will need another coat, but that's fine because I'm going to add some metals to it now. So I've pulled out some flowers, some of the big, large paper flowers as well. So the idea was pop one up on that corner, one on that corner, and then we've got some I don't know whether I'd put it on the inside or the outside. And I'm really sorry if you can hear my stomach. It's decided it's going to make a lot of noise. Right, so the leaves. These large leaves. Well, that one's a feather. But they're from the Where are they from? They're from the Mixedmedia Embellishment Kit. Did I have it? No, I don't. Yeah, I think it was. So I've pulled out all blues, but I'm also thinking now I might add some pink. I've pulled out the, well, obviously I used the dark denim chalky paint on. This came down through here. The dark denim chalky paint on the front of the door. Okay. Maybe a minute, please. Thank you. Cogage as well. I was going to pop in. Let's pop one. Down there as well. And maybe. Maybe one under there. Oh, sorry, I have major issues with left hand and it picks and chooses when it decides it's going to work. What does that look like? Stuck too many noses. You're too big. No, you're not. I think I'm happy with that one. So let's do this side. Scissors. I need to be a bit careful with this side because obviously the door opens. So pop that in there. Are you too big? Too big. There you go. Yeah, maybe. Right, so I need a smaller one. What have I got? No one. Yeah. Let's close that. Let's add some leaves. So need a small one. Now I'm looking at that, I don't think I want that one there. No, that's better. Yeah, I like the look of that. Right, I will stick all the metals down and give them a coat of gesso. And then I'll be back. So the metals are still a little bit wet, but they've had two coats of the new cream gesso. And I'm just gonna add a bit of texture paste here and there to the die cuts on the archway. Sorry, I don't know whether my head was in the way then or not, but I caught it with the camera with my head. So I'm just laying small amounts down and then stippling it slightly just to give it a bit of age. And texture. And just constantly moving the canvas around to make it easy for me to get to the areas that I want to add the texture paste to. was too straight a line. Right, what we're looking like. Little bit over there, and then that's it. So I'll dry that off. I'm doing it again, aren't I? I did this with crackle paste in the previous video. Said, yep, that's it, and then still carried on. It does need a little bit of that. I'm trying to rush that bit because we got aeroplanes keep coming in and out, going to the airport. So I have to keep pausing. Right. Is that enough? Yeah, I think it is. Right, I will dry this off and give it a coat of cream gesso. Right, so the texture paste is dry and I've given it all a bit more cream gesso. So the next step is to add a bit of colour. So I'm using the Pretty Chalky Paint Dark Denim again. And I've put some onto my mat and watered it down. So I'll just spray a little bit of water onto the canvas. Rid of the big drips that have gone down the side. A little bit more up here. Are we in short still? Yes. mop some of that up. Right, I'm going to dry that off. So that's the dark denim all dry. So now I'm going to add in some of the strawberry shake chalky paint. Only a small amount. So I've taken some out of the pot and I've watered it down. So where do I want it? I don't know. Probably not there. I think I've got it a bit thick on the brush. Doesn't seem to want to move as well as the denim did. But then I don't normally use pink. Play nice. Doesn't look like the right way around.
Right, I think that's enough. I'll dry that off. No, all dry. Alright, let's stick the door on. I did have to do a double take then because I thought I was trying to stick it with gesso. Yeah. Which is what I have a tendency to do if I don't move it out of the way. But it's fine. It's the matte gel medium. Let's turn that like that. You in the right place? Right, flowers. You in there. That one. Yeah, I've got some of the excuse me, small I call them trendles. They're from the Pretty Dreams die set, and I'm going to leave these white. Should have left it where it was. Do I or don't I? You can go on the petal, aren't you? Lift, thank you. All right, so that's that side done. Let's do the top side and turn it around because you'll just brush that. You there, and then you there, or was it the other way around? I think it was the other way around. Right, let's move those down. Let's add in these. actually. Come on. And I pulled the other one that was up there out because I like it where it's overhanging out of the corner. So let's stick that one back in underneath down the bottom. A little bit more. Right. Add in some pearls. So I'm using the vintage pearls. Where's all the little ones? Have I used all the little ones? Oh, didn't want that many. The pearls come in, the vintage pearls, mermaid pearls, and posh pearls, which are the cream ones, and the pearls don't have holes in, and the mermaid and the vintage have got different hues going around them. Got different sizes as well. I've probably chucked enough on there. I'm not going to use all of those. It's always the smaller ones that I use first. I very rarely use the larger ones, so maybe I should. Alright, let's find a brush. And this is where I'll spend hours trying to place the pearls. The same as I did doing the door. Alright, there's one. No longer wants to work. Come on, in you go. Thank you very much. I forgot they were there. Let's move those before I end up throwing them everywhere. Loose one. Run away. You go in underneath that petal a bit more. And that. So you're just poking out. That's better. Got some of the little teeny tiny bumblebees as well. So I'm going to put a bumblebee. And a big flower. Will you go under a bit more? Oh, I'll just stick to my nail. Thank you, that's a bit better. That was a good shot. Tweezers are getting too gloopy. That's there. Put another bumblebee on the white flower down the bottom as well. Oh, like that. That's obviously where that one wants to go. I will pop you there. There. Right, some pearls up the top. Come here.
little one. And get in under there. No, let's not try doing it. Why?
Right, last bumblebee.
Thank you.
Well, I think I'm happy with that. So, excuse me. To create this canvas, I use the Pretty Scenic 3D Door with crackle gel, crackle paste, cream gesso, dark denim, chalky paint. Used flowers from the paper flower collection, trendles from the Pretty Dreams die set, vintage pearls, diddy bumblebees, leaves, metal leaves, the metal cogs. What else have we got in here? Texture paste. The bricks are from the Gothic, Pretty Gothic window, and obviously you've got the Pretty Gothic window in the background. And can get there without pulling it off the canvas, because it won't be stuck properly yet. Yay, didn't get caught on any of the flowers. Thank you for joining me today, and I hope you have enjoyed the inspiration. All products are available from prettygetsgritty.co.uk.
And
hope you enjoy the rest of today's inspiration from Sam and from Corolla. Thank you. See you in the next one. Bye.